We were talking that today we are going to discuss cephalosporin. Okay, so cephalosporin kya hai? We were talking about cell wall synthesis inhibitors, right? So cell wall synthesis inhibitor mein humne pehle baat kiya penicillin ke baare mein, right? So today we will be discussing another cell wall synthesis inhibitor, that is cephalosporin. So cephalosporin, they are divided into 5 generation, okay? First generation, second generation, third generation, fourth and fifth generation, okay? The first generation is effective only to gram-positive bacteria. It is more like penicillin. First generation is more like penicillin. Second generation, it is effective to gram-positive, gram-negative and anaerobic bacteria. Okay, so this have to remember anaerobic second generation. Okay, this have to be remembered. This is an MCQ. Okay, then third generation is effective against gram positive, gram negative, and it has the widest spectrum of activity. Widest spectrum of activity. Okay, the third generation. And the fourth generation is effective against gram negative, and the fifth generation is effective against MRSA. What is MRSA? Methicillin resistant staph aureae. We know that none of the cell wall synthesis inhibitor are effective against MRSA. Only the fifth generation, this is a question, only fifth generation cephalosporin are effective against methicillin resistant staphylococcus aureus. Okay, other beta lactam antibiotics are not effective against MRSA. Okay, then this I told, first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, fifth generation. Okay, there are different drugs. So how to remember? Every generation starts with ceph. So how we can remember? So here is the trick to remember. See, first generation, first is one, right? And A is the first alphabet. So in the first generation, every cephalosporin has A in it. Okay, you see A. So cephazolin, cephalexin, cephalothin, cephaloridin, cephadroxyl. Every drug have A in it. Okay, I have marked it in red so that you can see, visualize it, have A in it. So we can remember first generation like this. Okay, second generation we'll talk later, third generation we'll talk later, fourth generation we'll talk now. So fourth generation kya hai? Fourth generation mein there is PI. Okay, agar A nahi hota hai, A hota hai, so you remember that it is first generation. Okay, and if there is PI, you remember that it is fourth generation. Now fifth generation kaun sa hota hai? There is ROL. Okay, ROL is fifth generation. Fine, ROL is fifth generation. Now how to remember the second generation and the third generation? Third generation, how we will remember? Third generation ka N mein kya hota hai? 1, me and 10. Okay, except this moxalectam. Okay, moxalectam, you have to remember that moxalectam is third generation. Ye aapko khud se yaad rakhna padega ki ye third generation hai. Other you can remember through the trick, third generation 1, me and 10, but there are some exceptions. Okay, like here cephazolin A is there. But here in second generation also we find a drug with A, and that is cefaclor. So this is the exception, you have to remember. Okay, cefaclor, although it has A in it, it is second generation. Fine, and this, although cefuroxime, although it has me in it, it should be third generation, right? But it is second generation. So how we can remember cefuroxime? See, cefuroxime mein U hai and me hai. U and me. How many people are there? 2 people. right? So this is second generation. You remember like that, you and me, two people, second generation. Fine, you can remember this. Everyone, please, I want to hear something from you. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Okay, samajh mein aaya sab kuch?
Okay.
I think you need to revise again, right? Revise karna zaruri hoga, theek hai? To A jahan pe hai, wo first generation hai. Exception kya hai? Cefaclor. Cefaclor is an exception, second generation. Okay? Then third generation mein kya aata hai? One, me and ten. Okay? और एक है मोक्सालेक्टम, ये आपको खुद से याद रखना पड़ेगा मोक्सालेक्टम. फोर्थ जनरेशन में क्या होता है? पी आई. ओके. एंड फिफ्थ जनरेशन रोल. यू रिमेम्बर कि देयर इज अ फैट गाय जो हु इज ईटिंग फाइव रोल्स. ओके. फाइव रोल मतलब क्या? रोल जो वेज रोल, एग रोल, वट एवर रोल इज देयर, फाइव रोल. ओके. फाइव इज ए लाइक क्या बोलते हैं, राउंड फिगर होता है ना. हाँ, आई मीन राउंड फिगर तो 10, 15, 10, 20 होता है, बट फाइव इज ऑल्सो ए टाइप ऑफ राउंड फिगर, राइट? फाइव. तो यू रिमेम्बर फाइव रोल. ओके. ही हैज रिटन फाइव रोल. सो यू रिमेम्बर इट लाइक दिस. एंड दिस वन सेफुरोक्साइन, सेफुरोक्साइन, यू एंड मी. सो देयर आर टू पीपल. सो दिस इज सेकेंड जनरेशन. ओके. फाइन. Now, we have to remember this bile-secreted cephalosporin. So, why we need to know about this? Bile-secreted, matlab, jo cephalosporin are secreted in the bile. Why it is important? Because we will know which are safe in renal failure. Okay? So, some drugs are not safe in renal failure. So, we can give them the bile-secreting drug. Okay? Bile-secreting drug, if you give them, that will not be touching the kidney and it will pass through the feces. Okay? And so there will be no problem with in renal failure. So what are the drugs including in bile secreted cephalosporin? There is one drug. One drug, cefoperazone, ceftriaxone. Aap bologe, maine bola one drug, but there is two drugs. See, it ends with one. Okay? So you remember bile, B is two, right? And O is 1. 1, 2. Okay, 1, 2. You remember like that. 1, 2. Bile se B hota hai. Bile se B hota. Bile B and it is 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. You remember like this. 1 or 2. Okay. Next. Now, this one we studied the bile secreted cephalosporin. But what are the bile secreting? My antimicrobial agent. We have studied only about cephalosporin, right? But there are other antimicrobial agents which are also secreted in the bile. So what are they? You can remember with the mnemonic CEF or safe in renal disease. Okay? So CEF, ye dono humne pad liya, one, cefoperazone and ceftriaxone. Then we have got rifampicin. It is an anti-tubercular drug. Then erythromycin. Erythromycin is an macrolide. Nephcillin is an penicillin. Okay, ampicillin is a penicillin. Lincosamides mein aata hai clindamycin, and doxycycline belongs to tetracycline. So you remember this mnemonic, CEF in renal disease. Okay, so these are the antimicrobial agents which are safe in renal disease. Okay, so yaad rakhna hai ye aapko, theek hai, this mnemonic. So what is nephicillin? I wrote it down here. Nephicillin is a penicillin derivative antibiotic. Okay, nephicillin, if you have not heard before, okay, it is not so common. So this is penicillin derivative. Okay, next. So anti pseudomonal. Pseudomonal matlab kya hai? Pseudomonas bolke bacteria hai. So we need to study some drugs which are anti-pseudomonal. So anti-pseudomonal cephalosporin. Okay. So kaise yaad rakhenge? Dekho, isme kya kya aata hai? Cefepime, cefpirome, cefoperazone, ceftazidime. Okay. How to remember? See, isme hai pime. Okay. So pime se yaad rakho, prime. Okay. So Prime Minister, who was the first Prime Minister of India? Jawaharlal Nehru. So you remember Prime, okay? So Prime, Prime se yaad rakho Prime Minister, that is Jawaharlal Nehru, okay? So what we got during his tenure? We get Azadi, right? So Ceftazidime, Azadi, yaad rakhna aise, theek hai? So this is also anti-pseudomonal, okay? Then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru was very fond of foreign tours. Aise yaad rakhna. So he went to Rome, okay? He went to Rome, okay? And one ye aapko khud se yaad rakhna hai, Cefoperazone. So maybe you can remember one time he went to Rome, okay? So Cefoperazone ye aap khud se yaad rakho, theek hai? So yaad rahega Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, we got Azadi, Azadi during his time, okay? Then he went to Rome, and one time he went to Rome. Now, what is most effective anti-pseudomonal cephalosporin? That is Ceftazidime, Azadi. Bolte hai na, chin ke lenge Azadi. So you remember, Azadi is most important for us, right? Freedom is most important. So freedom, jo Azadi hai, Ceftazidime is the most effective anti-pseudomonal cephalosporin. So you remember it like this, okay? Next, so that day I was talking about disulfiram reaction, right? So disulfiram like reaction matlab kya hai, wo sara drugs, those cannot be given with alcohol. If a person is alcoholic, he should not take these drugs, okay? So what is disulfiram reaction? That day I told you that I was having some doubt, but actually I was right what I was telling you. So I have got the definition today. A disulfiram like drug is a drug that causes adverse reaction to alcohol, leading to nausea, vomiting, flushing, dizziness, throbbing headache. So ye sara symptom hota hai. Disulfiram matlab ek drug, uske saath alcohol liya, to kya hoga? Nausea ho sakta hai, vomiting ho sakta hai, there is flushing. He is advised not to drive a vehicle after taking that drug, okay? So disulfiram reaction matlab kya hai? After taking alcohol, and if you take that drug, you should never ride. Only alcohol still you can ride, but after, if you take that drug and you take alcohol along with that, you should never drive. There are severe chances that, there are high chances that there might be some accident, because there will be headache, throbbing, nausea, vomiting, all those symptoms will be there, and hangover like symptoms, okay? So what are those drugs, okay? These drugs includes cefoperazone, moxalectam, cefotetan, and cefomendol. I'm extremely sorry, there is no mnemonics to remember this. You have to remember by itself. Ye char drug aapko yaad rakhna padega, okay? Cefoperazone, moxalectam, cefotetan, and cefomendol, okay? So disulfiram para. Now these same drugs are also should not be given to patient who have symptoms like hemophilia. Why? Because it decreases the prothrombin level and predisposed to bleeding. So what are the drugs? Drugs are cefoperazone, moxalectam, cefotetan, and cefomendol. So ye char drug aap yaad rakhna, okay? This is very important, okay? So next we will be talking about some MCQs. I have got some MCQs, and I think time is up. I'll share you another link so that we can solve the MCQ. But before going to MCQ, I would like to revise all what we have studied so far. So cephalosporin cell wall synthesis inhibitor, right? First generation, second generation, isme se sabse important yaad rakhna hai, second generation anaerobic mein kaam karta hai, fifth generation MRSA, fifth generation yaad rakho MRSA, okay? Only beta lactam antibiotic which works again MRSA is fifth generation. Yahan pe A jahan pe hoga, that is first generation, okay? Except cefaclor, which is second generation, you and me second generation, one me and 10 is third generation, okay? Fourth generation kaise yaad rakhenge? PI jahan pe hoga, PI or 4 or pi, okay? 4 or p 4 4 something like that. Phonetically it's similar, right? 4 p आ जाता है, 4 के बदले f लिखने के बदले p लिख दो, या f को f ऐसे होता है ना, तो इसको ऐसे बना दो, p हो जाता है ना, तो 4 ऐसे याद रख सकते हो. फिफ्थ जनरेशन रोल, एक याद रखो कि एक मोटा सा आदमी है, एक मोटा सा आदमी है, वो क्या किया, 5 रोल, वेज रोल, एग रोल, व्हाटएवर रोल, ही हैज ईटन 5 रोल. ओके, देन सेफ इन रेनल फेलर. ओके, सो व्हाई बाइल सीक्रेटेड सेफालोस्पोरिन सेफ इन रेनल फेलर, व्हाट आर द ड्रग्स, सेफोपेराजोन एंड सेफ्ट्रायोक्सोन. ओके, देन ये सारा मैंने याद करने बोला, सेफ इन रेनल डिजीज, सेफोपेराजोन, सेफ्ट्रायोक्सोन, देन रिफैम्पिसिन, एरिथ्रोमाइसिन. रिफैम्पिसिन क्या है, एनीवन वुड लाइक टू टेल, रिफैम्पिसिन क्या है, एंटी ट्यूबरकुलर. एरिथ्रोमाइसिन क्या है,
मैक्रोलिड,
मैक्रोलिड.
नेफ्रिलिन,
पेनिसिलिन डेरिवेटिव,
एम्पिसिलिन,
पेनिसिलिन.
निकोसेमाइड में क्लिंडामाइसिन आता है, और डॉक्सीसाइक्लिन क्या में आता है,
टेट्रासाइक्लिन.
एडवर्स इफेक्ट ऑफ टेट्रासाइक्लिन, एनीवन कैन टेल मी,
नेफ्रोटॉक्सिसिटी.
इन डेंटिस्ट्री व्हाट इज द रिलेवेंस,
डिस्कलरेशन ऑफ बोन एंड
टीथ. यस, वेरी गुड, येलोइश डिस्कलरेशन ऑफ टीथ. ओके, फाइन. सो नेफ्रिलिन बताया मैंने, देन एंटीसीडोमोनल. प्राइम मिनिस्टर वेंट टू रोम, आजादी, that azadi is most important for us. Okay, then disulfiram reaction you have to remember by yourself, and this jo predispose to building we have to remember by yourself.